गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीबॉडी. सो वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस टू एक्टिविटीज ऑफ कैश फ्लो स्टेटमेंट. वन इज कैश फ्लोज फ्रॉम फाइनेंसिंग एक्टिविटी एंड कैश फ्लोज फ्रॉम इन्वेस्टिंग एक्टिविटीज. सो टुडे वी विल डिस्कस द लास्ट एक्टिविटी ऑफ द स्टेटमेंट, दैट इज कैश फ्लोज फ्रॉम ऑपरेटिंग एक्टिविटीज. सी स्टूडेंट्स, वन थिंग आई हैव जस्ट टोल्ड यू दैट इन फाइनेंसिंग वी हैव यूज इश्यू ऑफ शेयर्स, इश्यू ऑफ डिबेंचर्स एंड लोन. इट मीन्स इन अ लाइबिलिटी साइड ओनली करंट लाइबिलिटीज एंड रिजर्व एंड सरप्लस इज लेफ्ट. Moreover, in case of investing activities, we have used fixed asset, money invested in fixed asset as well as an investment. It means here current assets are left. Now we have to show the effects of current liabilities, current assets and reserve and surplus in operating activities. You all know that current liabilities means those activities, those liabilities which will be paid off within 1 year. So within 1 year means that is a part of operations. So that is why we have to take the effect of current liabilities, current assets and reserve and surplus. One thing more I want to tell you, I have already told you that in case of operating activities, we have to take all the activities which are related to our sales, purchase, manufacturing, office. So all those expenses we have to take, but where the cash is inflowing or outflowing means if there is any transaction where there is no cash flows, that we have to add back in our net profit in order to show the net effect. See students, generally we take the profit that is after interest and tax, means after deducting all the activities. But in case of cash flow statements, because we have to take only those transactions where cash is being affected. So if cash is not being affected, then we have to add back all those non-cash and non-operating activities where our cash is not affecting. So let's start it. So we will start this cash flow statement with our net profit, because our net profit, loss and profit from sale of fixed assets, all these things are related to our general operations of the business. So this will be started with net profit, right? So whatever the net profit or loss is given, we have to write here. If it is in a plus form, then write. If a positive balance is given, then write down. Otherwise, you have to write in bracket, right? Now, adjustment for depreciation. See students, because depreciation is a non-cash expense. So now, because we have to show only cash affecting activities, so it will be added back. So we will add back this depreciation. Again, goodwill write-off. You know that in case of goodwill, we don't receive any amount, right? This is just the estimate of reputation of the business. So that is why if we have our writing of any goodwill, because there is no inflows as well as outflow, it will be added back. Then preliminary expenses. Preliminary expenses are those expenses which occurs before the date of commencement. बिजनेस के शुरू होने से पहले होते हैं. तो बेटा क्योंकि ये बिजनेस से पहले ही हो जाते हैं, तो क्योंकि दीज आर शोन इन पी एंड एल स्टेटमेंट, बिकॉज दीज आर ऑलरेडी हैपेंड बिफोर कमेंसमेंट ऑफ बिजनेस. इट मीन्स द पेमेंट इज ऑलरेडी बींग मेड. सो अगेन इफ दे आर रिटन इन पी एंड एल स्टेटमेंट, बट बिकॉज देयर इज नो इनफ्लोज एंड आउटफ्लो, बिकॉज इट इज ऑलरेडी डन बिफोर द कमेंसमेंट, सो इट विल बी एडेड बैक. Then is underwriting commission. See, underwriting commission is an expense, but because underwriting commission is paid in case of issue of shares or debentures, right? So that is why it means it will be considered, it must be considered under at the time of issue of shares and debentures. But because this is shown there also, the second effect is there. So now we cannot consider any transaction twice, so we have to add this back because this is already deducted in case of financing activity. Then is discount on issue of debentures. Same, if we are issuing discount, it doesn't mean that we are receiving any money. So discount, this is an expense, but this will be included under issue of debentures. So because there is no impact on cash, it will be added back. Again, loss on sale of fixed asset. If we are selling goods on loss, it doesn't mean that we are paying money. It means we are receiving less amount. But because for loss, there is no inflows and outflows, it will be added back. Then is profit on sale of fixed asset. Again, if you are receiving money in excess, it means that is from the that value is from the sale of that fixed asset. Right, because that profit is already mentioned in case of fixed asset, it is already being received, so it will be deducted here. So After adding all the non-cash and non-operating activities, we will get profit before working capital changes. Working capital means the effect of current changes in current assets and current liabilities. Now we have to show. See, now either there will be increase in fixed in current assets or decrease in current assets, as well as increase of current liabilities and decrease of current liabilities. Now you see, increase in current liabilities means we have invested money in stock or purchases. It means if our asset is an increase, it means we have spent money. So if we have spent money, there is outflow, so it will be deducted. Then if there is decrease in current asset, means if we have sold stock, it means we are receiving money. Receiving money means there is inflows of cash, so it will be added. There is increase in current liabilities. Increase in current liabilities means, for example, we have purchased goods on credit from the supplier. It means abhi bhi hamara cash increased hai because we have purchased goods on credit. So jab tak hamara cash increase rahega, we have to add this back. Now decrease in current liabilities means we have made the payment. So if we have made the payment, it means there is decrease in liabilities outflows. So we will this deduct it. Now after adding and deducting all these working capital changes, what we have to do? The amount that we will get is cash generated from operating activities. Right? Now you all know that because we are considering all the operating activities and tax is also a part of operating activities, then what we have to do? We have to give cash or we have to pay tax to the government. So after generating cash from operating activities, we have to deduct tax. So we have to write less tax paid, right? So after deducting tax, the balance that we will get, if it is in a positive form, that we will write net cash from operating activities. Or if the amount is in a negative form, then we will write net cash used in operating activities. Similarly, in case of investing activities, we have to write down either net cash from investing activities or used in activities. Same in case of financing, after adding and deducting all the amount relating to the same activity, we have to write net cash flows from financing activities or used in activities. So after getting all the final amounts, you will see that your final amount will be equal to 3000. The balance you will get 3000. So this is how we have to consider our cash flow statement. Now you can do all the questions related to cash flow statement and please send me your queries. Thank you so much.